Okay, in this video, we'll take a look at four different ways to add characters to circles in PowerPoint. So we'll begin with probably the simplest version or simplest approach, and that is just to crop a character or image to a specific shape. So I do have my character already selected here. It doesn't really matter. I'm going to go over my selection pane. It doesn't matter what kind of character you're working with. I have a content library character from Articulate, but any kind of character, illustrated or photo, is going to work. And I have what we like to refer to as a circle or oval here on the slide. So the first thing I want to do is crop my character just a little bit so I can scale her up a little and kind of position her where I'd like in the circle. So with the character, I just double click, brings open my picture format tab, and I'm just going to choose crop. And the first thing I just want to do is just do a regular type torso crop and scale her up a little bit just to size. It's going to be a little bit easier if I bring her to the front. So I'm just going to right click and choose bring to front and a position over the circle. For this example, I want to make sure that the character's head is within the circle or maybe just a little bit off the top. But basically I need to position the character where she needs to be within the circle. So that's probably fine. I can always come back in here and modify, but a little bit of her head will be cut off. With the character roughly in place, just go to the picture format tab again, this time crop, but click the bottom part of the crop and you'll see the crop to shape. So I want to choose the oval shape, and that makes an oval, sort of an egg shape oval, so it's not perfectly square. So what I want to do now is back to the crop tool, click the bottom half, and I also have this option here to crop the shape to a square, a 1x1. So if I choose that, and that'll make a perfect square. Now I will want to move the character around a little bit inside of this shape, just so I can get the character roughly where I want her. I'm going to bring her up a little bit. And what you'll notice is based on the size of the crop, it may not be large enough or it might be too big for your circle. So if I select the circle right here, and I go to picture shape, I can see that the height and width is 401. If I make my character match those same dimensions, picture shape, and then I go to 4.01, and it should already be the same aspect ratio, then I can perfectly center the character in there. And that's basically it. You can always modify the positioning. So if I wanted to change how much of the character shows here, I can double click the character. And once I have the crop tool, I can move the character, you know, all around within the circle. Maybe you want to just, you know, a little bit lower, so you leave a little bit more headroom. That's totally fine. Just depends on what you want to do. And then lastly, well, another thing, there's always more, maybe not last, but you could select the oval. And if you wanted, whoop, not the character, maybe I'll just move her over, make a copy of the shape, and then you can make a different border and put that on top if you want to do something special or different with it. So a lot of different ways to further modify that, but the crop to shape, by far, probably the quickest way to add a character to a shape. Okay, so we'll look at another way, and this is another simple way. This is using a transparent circle, but we're gonna need to duplicate the character. So I have another character and an oval already set up. Going to follow a lot of the same process here. I'm going to begin by just cropping my character roughly to where I want him. So with the crop tool, I'm just going to create a torso shot. That looks fine. And got to bring him to the top. So I guess I could use my selection pane and just drag up a selection for the character. All right, fine. We'll take a look at that. Now I'm going to remove the fill. I don't want to fill here for this circle. So with the circle selected, we have shape format, and we just need to turn off that outline. You'll shape fill, no fill. Did I already do the outline first? Let's try that one more time. Shape fill, no fill. Moving a little bit too fast here. There's my outline, and I need to beef this up to a much higher weight. So under weight, you'll see it only goes up to 6. That's not going to be high enough, so I'm going to choose more lines, and let's try something around, we'll start with 20 and see how that works. That might be a little bit small, maybe 30. All right, that's probably a good starting point. So I have 30 right here for the outline. I'm gonna move my character roughly where I want him, but you can see that the character's arms are sticking out. So I'm gonna send him to the back, right click, and we'll choose send to back. So now he's below the circle. It's not heavy enough for the way this example works. So I am gonna select my circle here, and I'm gonna beef that up to 40, and that's going to be a little bit better. So he's still coming out of the bottom a little bit. You see how his arms are? So I could start to crop him. Another thing I could do is maybe just extend the torso down a little bit farther. See how that looks? So picture format. It's not an exact science here. We'll bring that down and see how it looks there. There we go. So that's fitting pretty well. If you felt like you wanted to see more of him, you could always scale down a little bit. So there's a little bit more of the background behind him. And then if you need to make him a little taller, once again, we can keep moving that crop down. So it is sort of this little dance between the crop and the resizing. So that's a little bit better. Okay, once I have the character, I do want to make a copy of him. So once I have him cropped where I like, I'm just going to hold down the control key, click and drag to make a copy and put that up here on top. Just make sure they align, and PowerPoint does a really good job aligning. So you can see the guides helping me align to the bottom character. And now all I need to do is just crop upward somewhere toward the middle, just enough to get him out of the top of the circle. So with the character selected, crop, and we'll bring that up. You could go midway. So we really have two characters, two versions of the same character, but we have one that's really given us the outside the circle look, and then the bottom one that's cropped gives us the inside. And you could see that if you wanted to add a circle for accent to the very back circle, and then it doesn't even have to be a perfect circle. With that selected, maybe make it yellow, right click, and choose send it back. So we have a transparent circle, right? And we're really just using the outline and then using kind of a stacking technique here with the character to create that extra pop-out effect. So a little different than what we saw when the character is actually inside of the circle. Let's take a look at another option, and that is a combination of the two that we just looked at. So we're going to begin by cropping the character to the shape, duplicating the character, and then we can achieve that character sort of popping out of the shape as well. So where's my selection pane? Cool. All right, begin by cropping the character, sort of the same process here, at least initially. Probably could have begun with the crop character, and I'll scale her up. And then we're positioning her where we want over the circle. So probably a good starting point right there. With the character selected, I'm going to choose crop to shape, oval. Now, last time we used the aspect ratio. We don't have to use that. And you might find it even easier just to continue cropping the circle here. You see how you have the selection handles? We know that the circle, because it's a perfect circle, is also a perfect square. So you could use the crop handles to resize and snap to each of the parts of the oval, the width and the height, right? So the sides, and we just need to get that to line up. And you can see in the top right corner that we're at 401 again. So we know that this crop is a perfect circle. Click away to set it, and then you have your character in here. But what I'd like to do is I want her head to be a little bit outside the circle. So select the character, choose our crop tool, and then just like before, we can move the character all around because we already have that shape locked in to what we created with that oval. So we have a perfect square. There we go. Now, what I forgot to do was duplicate my character. So I'm going to grab the character, Control-C, Control-V, and I need to reset my character, reset picture, and just take the crop tool now, and we can drag this up a little bit. We just need to make sure we get her all back in there. A good pointer, just make sure you duplicate first, but it's not the end of the world because you can always get the character back, and you just need to reposition it. And then once again, we're going to crop the character so that she aligns with the bottom one. So crop again, bring it up. Might have to move it over just a tinge. There we go. And now it's all set up. And you can see you can add additional outlines or effects to that circle as well if you want to further enhance it. But nice combination between the crop to shape as well as the cropping effect where you're duplicating the character to make a second version of it. All right, one more just to look at it, and that is working with block arcs. So the advantage to block arcs is you can make some changes. You can come up with some creative color combinations using different colors for each part of the arc. And you can see where we have the semicircle arc at the top and then the semicircle arc at the bottom. So I'll turn these two on. Actually, I don't know why I saved a circle. Goodbye. I don't need that. Go up to the Insert tab and we'll choose Shapes. And this time we'll choose the block arc. So just select that and click once on the slide. Now what I'd like to do, just to lock in the aspect ratio, sometimes my shift key on this laptop doesn't work so well. I'm gonna right click this shape and I'm gonna choose size and position. And I just wanna come up to a size and properties and make sure my aspect ratio is locked. That way I don't have to hold the shift key down. I can, you know, resize this a bunch of times and not worry about accidentally nudging it, changing the aspect ratio. So that's locked in. Then you see we have these little transformation handles, these little orange transformation handles. I'm going to click this one and drag it over to make it a little bit thinner. So that's how we can adjust the width of that arc, right? We can make it really skinny, make it really fat, but somewhere between mildly thick is where you want it. What I'd recommend is setting the arc width first on the first arc and then duplicating it. If you try to set them up both together, you might just find that you're having to do a little extra work that you otherwise wouldn't need. So get these pretty much set up the way you like, and then from there, you can duplicate it. You can see that I need to move that up a little bit. I'm gonna hold down my control key, click and drag to make a copy, and we will just rotate 180 degrees. Okay, and position these in place. Now you'll notice though, how the outline creates that seam right there. So we definitely need to turn off, wait, what just happened? Too fast. We definitely need to turn off the outline for both of these. So I'm just gonna shift click the top and bottom arc, shape format, and then I'm just gonna turn off my outline and that creates a seamless circle. Select my character, picture format. Hey, look at the crop. We haven't done the crop in about 30 seconds, right? Crop the character and position the character really where you want, maybe a little too big on this one. And obviously we need to just do a little playing around with the stacking. So the idea is I can bring the character all the way to the front, but then it looks like the character's over the bottom one. So we actually want this bottom arc to also be at the front. So bring that to the front. And now we can slide the character in and out of that fake circle, I guess you'd say. And sometimes you can move the character off to the side. And if you want to add an accent piece again for that background, you certainly can do that. Okay, well, just a couple ideas for adding characters to circles. It's obviously a very fun graphic design technique and certainly can be used in presentation design as well as e-learning design.